Kieran, is Ollie in or out?
Morning, chaps. How are you doing?
Good, great, Kieran.
It's got to be out. Like, on what basis, if you look at his 2.5 years that he's been in charge, on what basis does he merit a new contract? Because if you look at Jose finished on 81 points, he finished second. He won the League Cup and he won Europa League. Ollie, he doesn't even look like winning anything at the minute. You know, yesterday he got outclassed by a guy that was sacked at Arsenal. I just think Man United, to go forward, they need an elite football manager at the club. Simon Jordan was right about Ollie. I don't think he's ever going to win anything at United. He's not going to take us to that level that we need to be at to compete with, you know, Man City, Liverpool. And it seems to be the same teams, sort of teams that they struggle against. How many times have Man United drawn 0-0 this season? And it's against that team that, you know, sits back, we've run out of ideas. He seems scared to make big subs. Rashford should have been hooked yesterday. He was awful. Bruno Fernandes, he looked lost. He didn't really come into the game. So why not change it? Why not bring Ahmed on? Why not bring Donny on? You know, Ollie made a living out of being a sub.
Kieran. He said it in his... Yep. Kieran, I totally agree with you. I feel that yesterday proved that, you know, Ollie's not an elite manager, because you've seen the game, you know, no one was performing. Why sign Van der Beek? Daniel James is on the bench. You know, was it a game maybe that Fred should have started? I just can't believe you cannot make any subs in 110 minutes when the opposition has made 5 in 90 minutes. I mean, where's your tactical awareness to make them changes?
Jack's another Manchester United fan who disagrees with Kieran and Gabby. He's calling it TalkSport. Jack, morning.
Morning, Jack.
Morning, gents. How are you doing?
Good,
very
thanks.
Well, thanks, Jack.
Good, good. I'd say Ollie in, really, because over these past 2.5 seasons, there has been progress. There's been massive progress, really. He's rebuilt the squad. He's got rid of the dead wood. He's rebuilt the squad. He's still rebuilding. For me, yeah, even though we've lost 4 semi-finals there and we lost the final last night, it's that big game mentality that maybe Ollie hasn't got yet, but he will learn his lessons by. And for me, next season, if we sign a few more players, like a centre-back, a centre-mid, a winger, and then if we're really lucky, Harry Kane, that, for me, would be challenging there.
But you look at Manchester City, and they could win a Champions League and the Premier League. I mean, as Man United fans, surely you need silverware. You want to be closer to the top of the table. Chelsea are going to get better next season. Liverpool are going to get better next season. For me, playing against Manchester United in the Premier League, they will never accept this failure.
Oh, 100%, Gabby. Completely agree with you, because you look at City and you look at, like they were saying before, sometimes Kevin De Bruyne can't even get a game. You look at that bench. If we bring in some more players there, then we will be competing, really, I do think. I really do think so. We've just got to have a stronger bench, because, like last night, 100th minute before he brought a sub on, does that mean that he doesn't trust his bench? Because you look at the players that were on the bench, like Fred, for me, I don't trust him at all.
Jack, where are you, Jack, in the goalkeeping situation, mate, with De Gea? Listen, MD can miss a penalty. We're not for a minute blaming him for missing the penalty. It can happen to MD. But where are you overall with the goalkeeper situation, mate?
For me, while De Gea has been a great servant for us, he's been absolutely fantastic. You can just tell over these last couple of seasons, he's not the player that he once was. And for me, maybe it should have been Dean Henderson in net last night. He's had a great back end to the season, to be fair to him. Apart from the Liverpool game, which wasn't the greatest, but apart from that, he's filled a gap where De Gea has been off for a few weeks. And for me, Dean Henderson should have played last night. But if I did see De Gea go in the summer, it would be with a heavy heart, because he has been a great servant for
well said. I agree. I think he's played his last game. Is it Ollie's last one? Here's Mark on the line. Mark, morning.
Morning, Mark.
Morning now, Ali and Gabs, how are you all?
Good.
What excellent, good, mate. How are you this morning? Disappointed last night, eh?
I'm starting to sober up a bit from last night, and I'm still a bit disappointed, yeah. So I can't understand Ollie's strategy with, like just said, the late subs. Rashford should have been off after 60, 70 minutes, because he was appalling, really. Pogba was quiet, Fernandes quiet. I mean, if we're going to bring in all these players, we'd probably need a new manager after Ollie, and, well, the situation with the Glazers isn't helping at the minute, because we've needed a full reform since the summer of 2018, just before Mourinho got sacked. That's how bad you look back on the signings We should have had like probably six in that summer, not three each summer. We need a massive overhaul this summer.
Mark, nice one. Thank you for your call this morning. Mark on the line there. So a bit of a mixed bag here. Gab, who should come in if he goes?
For me, I'll give it to I'll try my hardest to get Zidane.
Would you?
I think like someone like him can like get these players, give him that extra bit, the likes of Rashford, Pogba.
Don't smile a lot, Zidane, does he? He's very, very hooked here.
By the way, do you know what I was going to say to you, Gab? I'll have a think about this. What about, do you know who might be happy with Zidane leaving?
Gareth Bale.
Yep. Exactly.
Well, Gareth, he keeps saying that I know where I'm going, but I don't want to upset the apple cart at the moment. So
I wonder,
something's going on. So he's
I wonder if he knew what was going on behind the scenes, and that's what he was hinting at. Because everybody, listen, a lot of people, we spoke about it yesterday, a lot of people assumed, perhaps wrongly, that he might be thinking about retiring. What if he knows?
Yeah, the way he finished off the season, I mean, some of the goals he was scoring, you can tell there's a player in there, isn't there, still? Yeah. You know what I mean? He's still got a lot to offer, so I can't see him retiring.
TalkSport Breakfast with Alan Brazil. Thursday and Friday morning, 6 till 10. On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app, and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.